Welcome to week three, day three of the Bracket Smasher AM Crew training vlogs. It's another Jacked and Tan day. This is the last week where we're going to be rotating this rotation of exercises for our Jacked and Tan work, really focusing on developing upper back strength and it just absolutely hammering the posterior chain, as well as getting a little bit of arms in there as well, because, you know, who doesn't want to have big arms in their single or, you know, busting through their rash guard or their gi. So it's going to be a fun workout today. You'll see in this workout that we're actually doing a lot less reps than what we started with. We started with a 4 set of 6 rep scheme in week one, moved to a 5x5 or a 5x6 rep scheme in week two, and now we're going to be in a 6x4 rep scheme for a lot of these exercises. Some exercises are still going to have 6 reps just because it's not very conducive to be doing that low of reps. Like for something like hammer curls, doing sets of 4 on hammer curls isn't as beneficial, at least in my opinion, as opposed to doing 6 sets of 6 reps. But the purpose for today's workout is to use a little bit heavier weight than anything we've used for the past 2 weeks, so we can get a little bit more of that overload and create a little bit of a higher stimulus for our bodies to adapt to and have some fun. We've already done our super heavy work. We've already done our high volume, explosive and speed work. And now it's just kind of about broing out, hammering some accessories, building up those weak points so we can continue to decrease our risk of injury, increase our strength so that we can win more matches and get injured less. So follow along with the workout. We'll catch you guys at the end. There you go.
Well,
yes, sir.
Trying to go fairly heavy.
What'd you do last time?
I think it was this. Call and kiss and tell me. Word to my mama, I'm out of my llama, baby. Don't wanna see what that drama means.
The bent over row is one of the best exercises ever, but it's also one of the most bastardized and messed up exercises ever. And I think people get way too caught up on being excited on almost like deadlifting, where they get so excited on how much weight's on the bar, they just sacrifice all form of technique in the name of going heavy. And there's so many great lifters, so many great athletes that have sworn by doing heavy bent over rows. And I think a lot of athletes hear that and they think, oh, heavy means I must sacrifice all my technique and all my control of the movement. And that's not the case. And so for the bent over row, the way I like to coach the bent over row and I like to help my athletes do the bent over row is for them to treat it like another technical main lift. So take your time getting set like you would on a deadlift. Take your time really making sure that your grip is even and you're locked in like you would if you were getting underneath the bench. And then from there, once you get into that row position, which is gonna be something somewhere between almost parallel with the floor and about 45 degrees. The higher up you go, it's more like a super ugly shrug and less of a bent over row. But once you get into that position, you want to row with control and really make sure that you're feeling it in your back. Your back should be working the most. If you feel it in your arms, you're not doing it right. If you feel it all in your traps, you're not doing it right. and you don't feel anything except the bar slamming into your stomach, you're definitely not doing it right either. So watch how Kevin, Zach, and I do these bent over rows and try to emulate that part of your technique. Try to mimic how we're doing it here. That way you can enhance the quality of your bent over row.
Proven that if you do barbell rows, you instantly get women, you get ripped, you get tan just by doing barbell rows. That's it. That's all you need to do. It's recipe for life.
Yep. Yep.
Yep. Oh. And the pain is forever alive inside. Yes, sir.
How about that posterior chain, dog? Trying to put people in triangles like this guy. Or leg lock people with that.
Trying to get those
inside Sankaku Senkaku like this guy. You gotta hit that posterior chain, dog. If you're a jiu-jitsu or a wrestling athlete, really any athlete, and you want healthier elbows, because maybe some lovable spazzy white belt really cranked on your elbow. Or you got caught in something and you didn't want to tap and you know you may be suffering a little bit. If you want to take care of your elbows, one of the best things you can do is high rep banded extensions. Overhead, push downs, even you can mix all sorts of banded extension movements into your training for high reps, 25 to 50 reps per set. And what this does, it's actually going to help pump a ton of blood through the elbow joint, which is great for restoration and health, as well as building a little bit more muscle and making your joints a little bit more durable. You'll notice we do the same things with our hamstrings. We do a ton of volume on banded leg curls. You think about jiu-jitsu, there's so many positions where you're pulling your heel to your butt, whether you're in a triangle, whether you're in any sort of guard position, you have to have strong hamstrings and high reps by using a band. Is a great way to increase blood flow through the joint, get a little bit more restoration, make it a little bit more bulletproof so you can win more matches and get injured less.
Tries for the guys. Tries for the guys, baby.
Just finished up week 3, day 3 of our Bracket Smasher AM Crew training program. It was a pretty solid workout. We had a small group just because quite a few of us are competing. We got Anthony competing tomorrow in the Advanced Absolute at Grappling Industries. Or no. Sorry, Anthony, I forget what the name of the tournament. Grappling Industries or Grappling X, one of the two. And then we have Joe Bond competing tomorrow at Submission Pro Tour in a super fight. And then next week, he's going to be traveling to Southern California to compete at IBJJF Worlds. So it's awesome to see like the work that all these guys have been putting in and how they're able to kind of get that snowball rolling and build that momentum and taking it one training session at a time, really push all in on the concept of separation season, and now they get to show off their skills and show off the progress that they've made starting tomorrow. So I'm super excited and super fired up for them. As far as the training that I did, it was me, Zach, and Kevin. We did some heavy upper back work, a ton of work for the posterior chain, and had fun gangstering out on some Nordic curls and some heavy Cossack squats, which Cossack squats, guys, they're probably it's probably like one of my favorite exercises of all time. That being said, we're going into a little bit of a deload weekend. We don't have as many jiu-jitsu sessions going on this weekend because that means next week we start phase two of the Bracket Smasher AM Crew training program. So hope to see you guys there. You guys can follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Joshua Settledge. If you guys are interested in a free 4-week strength program, you guys can click the link below and check that out. And I'll catch you guys later.